Hello and welcome to this lecture. Today we are going to discuss deep vein thrombosis. And usually deep vein thrombosis occur in large leg veins and it occur above the knee. And it usually occur at popliteal, femoral or iliac veins. Clinically, local pain will be produced along with the edema and may be rapidly offset by collateral bypass channels, and it is asymptomatic in 50% of the patient and only recognized after they have been embolized and then leads to pulmonary embolism. And what is meant by embolism? We discussed last time that a thrombus will be formed and some section of the clot will travel to artery and it travel to your lungs where it can cause pulmonary embolism. How to diagnose deep vein thrombosis? Superficial or deep leg veins, the main thing, the site of the injury. Then it could be identified using ultrasound, using contrast venography. Or with the help of identification of important biomarker plasmin D dimer or fibrin degradation product. So this marker can be elevated in patient having deep vein thrombosis. Clinical correlation, thrombi are of clinical significance because they can obstruct arteries and vein both, and possible sources emboli. If the arterial thrombi obstruction on the coronary vessels or cerebral vessels, and it can lead to embolism later on, whereas venous thrombi may cause congestion and edema in vascular beds and cause obstruction. So thank you so much for today's lecture. Hope to see you again.